Hey everybody, it's Rob from Flail Throughs. This is Gundam Battle Operation 2, and I am back in my high-mobility Zaku. I believe this is the level 2. That's why I did that little side dash to check and see if the forced injection still redlined your thrusters, going by the slightly improved stats. But it appears to. I've got the level 2 missile launcher to simplified missile launcher, I think it is, to go with this. And yeah, I enjoy using this, so I figured I'd throw up a video with it. At the moment, though, I have got a PSA for everybody. My one friend, Salty Walty, who has shown up in quite a few of my videos, he's streaming now, and he will be streaming the Friday night fights. So, you know, even on the weeks when I can't make it, fights happen, so, you know, check out his YouTube channel. There'll be a link in the description, because, yeah. I think at the moment he's the only person generally streaming those. Avocado Zala used to do it on Twitch, but, life gets in the way, stuff happens, so yeah, Salty is the one who's doing it right now, and he's doing it on YouTube, so if anybody else streams and there are other perspectives, I will certainly link them so that you guys can, you know, see what goes on Friday and see for yourselves that I really only post the matches where I, you know, play worth a damn. But, yeah, so I love this missile launcher. I believe I have the quick loader on it, which, you know, given the long reload time on it, is actually fairly significant for this, because I forget whether, I think it's like 3% decreased reload time, but again, that's, at this stage, that's probably a couple of seconds at least, and it counts. But even without it, you know, the Zaku machine gun you have as a backup, it's low damage, but it has, you know, 100 rounds. So you can keep the fight going in between, you know, loads for this thing pretty easily if you try. And missed with the first one, but hit with like three others. Fumbled my weapon switching, or else I would have followed up with a downswing. Once it was too dangerous to do that, I just dropped back and took some pot shots with the machine gun. This is only a 3v3, so, you know, and that was just a complete mistake, which I will apologize for when I'm not, hopefully when I'm not, you know, in immediate danger. Yep, there we go. Sorry. It's so nice that you can see what the tells are now. Also, you can change the tells on the options screen, I found out. I haven't picked out any other than the default, because every time I think of it, I'm about to go into a match, but that's just how it is. I'll probably do some customizing next time I actually have the brainage for it. But yeah, I'm, like I said, you can do about 70, 80 damage a shot with the machine gun off of that. And of course, unlike Vulcans, it does carry some stun damage. So it's not a bad backup weapon. It's, you know, not tremendously damaging, probably a low DPS. But on average, I'm sure the damage per second works out okay between the rockets and the machine gun. Also, I'm nearly dead, and my legs are destroyed, so I'm going to try and take a shot before I get killed. I don't know if I'm going to hit anything. Yeah, I got a couple of shots in, but that machine gun that the enemy was using has more of a reach than I remembered, because I didn't think I was going to get away from that. So, now it's repair time. Crouching, just like in a mobile suit, crouching does increase your damage, or in this case, repair speed. Repair, you know, efficacy, whatever you want to call it. But now I am kind of pinned back here with 1,800 health, which is pretty much nothing. If I can get my shot off and actually make good use of it, that'd be great. But I'm not sure if I hit the striker's shield, missed it entirely, or if its maneuver armor just soaked the stun. But at any rate, that was not the best way I could have gone out. It happens. So we've got an airstrike ready here. They're about to take D, unfortunately. So, and it kind of happened all at once. We had an airstrike available, and they drained D, and it was just full. So I don't know what the deal is there. Since it's a 3v3, I'm the only one alive at the moment. So while I wait for everyone else to respawn, it's probably as good a time as any to be dropping bombs. And back to the Zaku. Yeah, I really do like this thing. I want to get the other high mobility, the R2 type. I want to mess with that a while, because I like the high mobility Zakus. And somebody was asking about this with yesterday's video. The specialization I was talking about with the Zaku F2, it is not the same thing as the environments that a mobile suit can... Man, that was a level 1 and it just dropped. It's not the same thing as the environment a mobile suit can operate in. This can operate either on ground or in space, and so can the R2 type, the high mobility late type Zaku. But the... I don't know about this one, I haven't looked, but the R2 Zaku has space specialization, which means even though it can run in both environments, it gets certain bonuses to its thruster recovery and some other things in space. Likewise, the specialization gives like ground exclusive things like the Gundam ground type, slightly faster thruster recovery than other mobile suits on the ground. What's really interesting is that none of the aquatic type mobile suits have ground specialization. Not one, even though they cannot be used in space. There are these Gox beam weapon, I think it is. It's the Zagok or the Agai, I forget which. One of the beam weapons on Zeon Mobile's aquatic mobile suits says that it's more powerful underwater. You know, all those things taken together, we're kind of extrapolating that one day we may actually get underwater environments for this game, and I think that would be great. And I am about to die because I am totally surrounded, and I'm not even going to have a chance to get my last two rockets off because my legs are shot. I was trying to dodge roll, and just sometimes I think it's latency again that dodge roll just won't take, and you'll just boost instead, which is, you know, kind of terrible because if you have no legs, you will fall over and be killed. But despite the fact that they're pushing us pretty hard, we have managed with 1 minute left to stay competitive here, which is not bad. We've got... Okay, that is... Yes, that is for real a 30-point lead. That is what that is. Yeah, and I... And this one, that's why I wanted to share this one. Because of the magic of understandable signals, I was able to send the signal fall back for now, and instead of charging forward, we all hung back and made them come to us. Because if they want to make up that 30 points, they have to either take a point or kill one of us. Now, if they had realized what we were doing and gone back and taken A, we would have lost. But instead they charged us, and since we, you know, had good cover, since we were staying together, and since they only had 19 seconds to kill one of us, it worked out pretty well. I did not manage to stop the striker from swinging, but I did manage to, slow it down long enough that it could not kill any of us. And that's the important part in this situation. I'm not sure, I think we killed somebody at the last second. Two people, possibly. So yeah, we won. And yeah, again, the ability to give tells that people can understand is literally, in this case, a game changer. We got at least one kill at the end there, but it did not register because it was at or after the last second, latency again. So we won by 30 points, all because, you know, I'm not going to take full credit for everything, but yeah, knowing to hang back and being able to communicate that concept to everybody else, that worked out well. So that is going to do it for today's Gundam Battle Operation 2. We'll be back soon with more, so until next time, everybody take care and have fun. Later!